Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to create and customize the SyncFusion Blazor polar and radar charts to visualize and compare multivariate data in the form of two-dimensional charts represented on axes starting from the same point. First, I will add the SyncFusion Blazor polar and radar series charts to the Blazor application. So, I will open the existing Blazor application, where I have added the Blazor chart to it. If you want to know the procedure for creating a Blazor application and adding a simple SyncFusion Blazor chart to it, then you can watch my Getting Started video, linked in the card above, and you can find a reference link in description for this video. Now, I will press F5 to run this application to show the default output of the chart. Here, you can see the default chart output with two axes, X and Y, with no data points displayed. Now, I will show how to add a polar series chart to the Blazor application. Before going any further, let me explain what radar and polar charts are. Using polar and radar charts, you can easily arrange the different variables with equiangular spokes that start at the center of the chart and end on the outer ring. Here, the January spoke indicates the January month temperature value, the February spoke indicates the February month temperature value, and so on. Now let's see how to write the code for adding a polar series chart with a line series plotting type to the application. To render a polar series chart, first, I need to define the chart series tag inside this chart series collection. I will set the chart series type as polar within this chart series tag. Then, I need to add the plotting type for the polar chart, so let me define the property draw type and set its value as line. Next, let me start populating the data for the polar series chart. Within this code block, I will define a model class chart data model with two fields, month and temperature, as I am going to populate monthly weather statistics data in the chart. Then, I will create a list chart data of type chart data model and assign an array of objects to it. Now, I need to assign this object chart data to the data source property and map the data source fields month to the X name and temperature to the YName properties of the series. Since most polar charts use categorized data on the x-axis, let me customize the x-axis category as category in order to display the month values on the x-axis of the chart. So, to enable this category axis, let me define a chart primary x-axis tag and set the value type property as category. Here, you can see the polar series chart with a categorized axis and defined data points. In this output, chart axis labels are placed between the ticks. If I want to place the axis labels on the ticks, then I will define the label placement property and set its value as on ticks. Look at the chart output displaying the axis labels on the ticks. Okay, now let's customize the y-axis of the chart with a custom range and label format to display our data points more clearly. To do this, first, I will define a chart primary y-axis tag within this chart code. Then, I will add the properties minimum, maximum, and interval with appropriate values to set a custom range for the chart. Along with these, I am going to display the temperature value in Celsius format by customizing the label format property of chart with the template value. So here, you can see a polar series chart with a custom range in the y-axis that ranges from minus 25 degrees Celsius to 25 degrees Celsius with an axis interval as 10. Alright, now let me set the main title for the chart to enhance its readability. So, I will define the title property and set its value as weather statistics. See the chart output with the title weather statistics. Next, let's enable data markers on the chart to display information about the data points. I will define a chart marker tag, and to enable the data marker, I will set the visible property as true. Along with this, I will also set a custom height and width for the marker. You can see the chart displayed with a data marker for every data point. Now let's make the polar series chart more interactive by adding tooltips to it. Within the chart code, I will define the chart tooltip settings tag. Then, to enable the tooltip, let me define the property enable and set its value to true. So, you can see in the output here, tooltips shown for every data point. Now, we have seen all about adding a polar series chart with the line series plotting type. Let's see how to change the series plotting type. The Blazer Polar Chart from SyncFusion offers many series plotting types, like line, column, area, stacked area, and so on. Now, I am going to render the polar series chart with the column series plotting type. So, let me change the draw type as column. To make its appearance more appealing, let me remove this chart marker section from the chart. Here, you can see the polar series chart with the column series plotting type. Next, we will see how to add a radar series chart with the line series plotting type. To add a radar chart, I will set the chart series type as radar and the draw type as line within the chart code. As I am going to display the line series plotting type, let me add the chart marker tag and define the properties, visible, height, and width with appropriate values. Now, you can see the chart output with the radar series chart. Here, by default, the start angle will be 0 degrees, and the radius of the chart will be 100. If I want to customize the chart start angle and radius, then I can add a start angle property and set its value as 45 within the chart primary x-axis. Along with this, I will define the coefficient property as 70 so that chart will be displayed with a radius of 70. Here, you can view the radar series chart with a customized start angle and radius. Let's recap. We have seen how to render the Blazer radar and polar charts with basic features like data markers, series plotting types, and tooltips. In my upcoming videos, we will learn about the SyncFusion chart axis types like category, numeric, logarithmic, datetime, and datetime category. If you would like to see the working example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see if you qualify for a free license key to use our Blazer products through our community license. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.